Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to teach about next endocrine gland is thyroid gland. Okay, thyroid gland. So thyroid gland is the largest gland. It is largest gland in the endocrine system. In the endocrine system, compared to all endocrine glands, it is the largest gland. Next, location. It's located in the neck region. Okay, it is located here, neck region. The thyroid gland is present the neck region on ventral side of the trachea. This is about location. Okay, it is located in the neck region. Next, it is bilobed structure. For example, it looks like this. Okay, it is bilobed structure. So two lobes are present, so that's why this is a bilobed structure. Next, two lobes are connected by a connection. That connection is called isthmus. Two lobes connected by isthmus. Okay, so this is about structure. So two lobes are present. Next, it is butterfly or H shaped structure. Okay, shape is H shape or butterfly shaped structure. So that's why it has two lobes. So that's why this is also called bilobed structure. Two lobes are present. Next, two lobes are connected by a connection is called isthmus. Next, coming to the internal structure of thyroid gland. So when we observe the internal structure, for example, here, this is the transverse section of thyroid gland. So here, this thyroid gland, the outer side, so it lined by a layer. Okay, so this is called thyroid capsule. Okay, outer layer is called fibrous capsule. Outer layer is called fibrous capsule. Next, inside, many globes, rounded globular structures are present. Rounded structures, which are called thyroid follicles. So many number of follicles are present inside the thyroid gland. Next, each follicle is lined by a single layer of epithelium. Okay, each follicle is lined by epithelial cell, that is called acinar cells of thyroid follicular epithelium. Okay, the follicle is lined by acinar cells of thyroid follicular epithelium. Okay, so here these are called thyroid follicles. Many thyroid follicles are present. Next, in between this thyroid follicles, a loose connective tissue is present here. So in between that space, loose connective tissue is present. In the loose connective tissue, some cells are scattered in the loose connective tissue. Some cells are scattered. So these cells are called parafollicular cells. Okay, so this is the structure of thyroid gland. So thyroid gland, externally it is lined by fibrous capsule. Next, inside, many thyroid follicles are present. Thyroid follicles are lined by acinar cells of thyroid follicular epithelium. Next, in follicle in thyroid follicles, the space is present in between the thyroid follicles. The space filled with connective tissue. In the connective tissue, many cells are scattered in the connective tissue. These cells are called parafollicular cells. So here, thyroid follicle secretes a thyroxine hormone. Thyroxine hormone. Parafollicular secretes the calcitonin hormone. Calcitonin and thyroxine hormone. So thyroid follicle secretes thyroxine hormone. Parafollicular cell secretes the calcitonin hormone. So that's why the thyroid gland secretes the two hormones. Okay, so this is about structure. Let us, we will discuss about the hormones of thyroid gland. So next, coming to hormones of thyroid gland. Hormones. So it secretes two hormones. Thyroid gland secretes two hormones. First one is thyroxine hormone. Second one is calcitonin hormone. The two hormones are secreted by the thyroid gland. So here, thyroxine hormone secreted by thyroid follicles. Thyroid follicles secretes a thyroxine hormone. The parafollicular cells secretes the calcitonin hormone. Okay, so first we will discuss about thyroxine hormone. So thyroxine hormone, so it thyroxine hormone, it's a amine hormone. It's a amine hormone, which means it's a derivative of single amino acid. So that is tyrosine amino acid. When iodine is added to tyrosine to form, okay, tyrosine binds with the iodine to form thyroxine hormone. So for the production of thyroxine hormone, iodine is very very essential. So iodine is compulsory for production of thyroxine hormone. The tyrosine amino acid is bind with iodine to form thyroxine hormone. Next, it is present in the form of two forms. It exists in the form of two. Okay, so that is T3, T4. Okay, so this thyroxine hormone is existed, or it is present in the form of two. T3, one is a T3, another one is T4 hormone. T3 means triiodothyroxine. Okay, T4 means tetraiodothyroxine. Tri means 3. 3 iodine molecules are present. Here tetra means 4. 4 iodine molecules are present. But both are same functions. Both have the same functions. So just the iodine molecule is different. Here 3 iodine molecules are present. Here 4 iodine molecules are present. But both shows the same functions. T3 hormone, T4 hormone. Next, coming to the functions of the thyroxine hormone. Okay, so mainly thyroxine hormone, it regulates the BMR. It regulates the BMR. BMR means basal metabolic rate. It regulates the basal metabolic rate by the two ways. It increases the cellular respiration increases the cellular respiration, or you can say increases the oxygen consumption rate. It increases the oxygen consumption rate, means more oxygen is consumed in our body to increase the production of ATP. Okay, so by this, it regulates the, means, or it increases the BMR, basal metabolic rate. So this basal metabolic rate is increased by these two ways: increasing of the cellular respiration and increasing of the oxygen consumption rate, and increasing of the production of ATP. So more ATP, more energy is produced in our body due to this thyroxine hormone. Okay, next, it is also regulates the body temperature. So it has regulates the temperature, body temperature in homeotherms. Okay, homeotherms means the organisms can maintain the constant body temperature. The birds and mammals are homeotherms. So in birds and mammals, this hormone is regulates the body temperature also. Okay, next. So it also regulates the protein metabolism. Also regulates the protein metabolism, metabolism and anabolism. Next, it also regulates the also stimulates the erythropoiesis. Also stimulates the thyroid gland is also stimulates the erythropoiesis. Erythropoiesis means the production of RBC, production of blood. Okay, blood cells from the bone marrow. Production of RBC from the bone marrow is called erythropoiesis. So that's why the thyroxine hormone is stimulates the erythropoiesis. Next, it is also helps in the protein metabolism. Next, regulation of BMR, basal metabolic rate. Mainly it regulates the basal metabolic rate by the increasing of the cellular respiration and increasing the production of ATP. So this is about thyroxine hormone. Next, coming to the calcitonin hormone. Okay, calcitonin hormone is secreted by parafollicular cells. Okay, so this is also called thyrocalcitonin, also called. Next, coming to the function, it decreases the calcium levels in blood. Okay, it decreases the calcium levels. Whenever calcium levels increased in our body, so that situation is stimulates the production of calcitonin hormone. So when the calcitonin hormone is present, it decreases the calcium levels, okay, in blood. So how it is decreased? By the different ways it decreases the calcium levels. Okay, main thing, it decreases the calcium levels in the blood by the so that excess amount of calcium ions sent to the bones. Okay, so in the bones they are stored. So in bones, the calcium ions stored in the bones. So that is a one way. So in this way, the calcium levels are decreased. So if excess amount of calcium ions are present in our body, the hormone is secreted into the blood. So this hormone, main function is that excess amount of calcium ions sent to the bones. So in the bone, they are stored in the bones. Next, one more, that excess amount of calcium ions releases to outside through the urine. So which means it sent to the outside, the calcium ions, that excess amount of calcium ions sent to the outside. So that's why main function of calcitonin, it decreases the calcium levels in blood. If excess amount is present, so that excess amount is removed by the two ways. One is the excess amount of calcium ions sent to the bones. One more, that releases to the outside through the urine. Okay, so this is about calcitonin. Next, thyroxine hormone. So both hormones are secreted by thyroid gland.